Indonesia has a very wide sea area, and abundant marine resources and make it known as a maritime country. One of the areas that has the potential for promising marine natural resources is the province of Bali. Several types of fish are found in the waters around the area of Bali, which turns out to be able to be exported abroad. But the Balinese themselves are always active in utilizing their natural resources for their daily needs, including in the realm of traditional culinary arts. If you always think that culinary in Bali is only limited in menu variants, you are wrong. Because here, there are also many dishes in the form of fish which can be found in various forms. In this episode, we will get to know one of the unique flavors of Bali, which will definitely be one of the recommendations when you visit this place. The current existence of the fisheries sector has become a sector that has an important role as a source of food, as well as providing a fairly large economic impact. More and more days, the government is very focused on utilizing Bali's strategic position and placing the fisheries and marine sector as one of the bases of Bali's economic development. One of the most famous fishery products is dominated by tuna. Balinese people always take advantage of this particular marine catch to manifest it in the distinctive taste of the secret spice. They work together and synergize for a peaceful life shared together. This is also for the sake of realizing the sanctity and harmony of Bali's nature and its content, to realize a prosperous and happy Balinese life, or known as Sat Kerti Loka Bali.
Om Swastiastu. Sat Kerti Loka Bali is to maintain the harmony of Bali's nature and its contents to create such a good life for Balinese people in Sekale and Niskale. And one of them is culinary, which has so many benefits and also philosophies for our life. And in this modernization era, I think culture can adapt with massive development, and Balinese people maintain their culture by including the elements of culture into tourism so that they can also preserve the culture too. There are many things that preserved by Balinese people, such as cultural, arts, religions, and also culinary. And when we are talking about culinary, one of the most popular culinary in Bali is sate lilit.
Sate lilit, or wrap satay, is certainly a familiar dish to us. Sate lilit is a mainstay dish that is often hunted by tourists when visiting the island of Bali. The term lilit in Balinese means wrapped, because the shape of the sate lilit is indeed wrapped around a thick and white skewer. Sate lilit is also usually made for offerings when the Balinese held a religious ceremonies or large events as a form of respect and appreciation to the gods. The process of making sate lilit has always been entrusted and carried out by men. Start from mixing the dough, slaughtering the animals, wrapped around until they grilled it. Because of the cooking process that involves men, sate lilit has a strong philosophical meaning in the life and virility of men.
Sate lilit is one of Balinese food that made by mashing the meat and then it wrapped into a bamboo stick. It describes about Balinese people, which are always united. And beside that, sate lilit also has philosophies about male virility, because in Bali, when we are cooking our mebat, it's always be done with men. This sate lilit is originated from Klungkung, but now this sate lilit is spreaded into another areas in Bali. And sate lilit can be made by pork, chicken, and fish. And if you want to try sate lilit, one of the most delicious sate lilit in Bali is located in Warung Pesinggahan Mertesari in Klungkung.
Perkenalkan, nama saya Udin, asal dari Klaten, Jawa Tengah. Saya ke warung Mertasari ini hampir rata-rata 2-3 bulan sekali. Dari saya kenal tahun 2004. Jadi saya yang paling suka di tempat ini adalah sate lilit sama sambelnya ini khas sekali. Beda sama warung-warung yang lain di sekitar sini.
The shop that we visited this time, located in Pesinggahan Village, Banjar Sukahati Street, precisely on the crossroad to Padang Badi or Goa Lawah. At first glance, this stall looks simple, but from opening to closing, this stall is almost full of customers, both from the local community around, tourists to state officials, who always come back to this place.
Swastiastu, nama saya Komang Yunianti dari Warung Sehat Mertesari. Ini saya dari generasi kedua dari penerus almarhum bapak saya Ineng Asade. Yang bikin sate lilit di sini berbeda sama di tempat lain. Kalau di tempat lain ada kelapa parutnya, kalau di sini daging utuh, daging tulen, tidak ada campuran apapun. Ikan sama bumbu-bumbu rempah-rempah alami aja. Kalau menunya dari dulu cuma ada sate lilit sama pepes, sama sayur, sambal, kacang, sama supnya. Tapi permintaan semakin banyak yang nyari yang nggak pedes, ditambahin sekarang jadi sate tusuk. Satenya yang digunakan dari ikan tuna, dominan dari ikan tuna, kalau enggak bisa ikan tongkol ataupun yang lainnya. Kami mengambilnya dari pengepul yang di desa Kusambe, biar lebih dekat. Kalau ada yang ikan segar, nyari di tempat di pantai sekitar sini. Hari biasanya menggunakan sekitar 100 kilo ikan yang sudah bersih, yang filet, tapi itu sudah bisa dipakai sup ikan, sate tusuk, sama sate lilit. Itu bisa menghabiskan sate sekitar 3.000-an sampai 5.000-an tusuk sate. kalau favorit pelanggan dari dulu sate lilit sama supnya. Karena itu yang jadi menu utama kami di sini. Warung Mertesari hanya beralamat di Desa Pesinggahan, Kecamatan Dawan, Kabupaten Klungkung. Tidak ada cabang di tempat lain. Kenapa dinamakan Mertesari? Kalau merte kan artinya makanan, sari itu sari-sarinya. Jadi Mertesari, sari-sari makanan mengumpul di tempat Mertesari ini. Berdiri sejak tahun 1996, tapi kalau dari berdirinya itu dari kecil-kecilan sudah dari tahun 90-an. Besarnya tahun 1996 dibikinin tempat yang agak lebih besar.
Mertesari Food Stall is a special place in processing tuna. White rice served with sate lilit or fish pepes, a cooking method with banana leaves as food wrapping with various other side dishes, is the result of the hard work of Wayan Dunia and her late husband named Nengah Sade. From selling on the roadside, now the shop is grow big and successful. Places for visitors are made diverse. Some are sitting in the pavilions, some are also on the tables and chairs that have been prepared. In addition to serving direct buyers, Mertesari food stalls also accept orders from various groups for various events. At least 100 kilograms of tuna consumed every day at this stall, so the supply must be added from other areas such as Benoa, Denpasar.
Kami belajar membuat sate lilit semenjak masih SD. Itu diajarin langsung sama almarhum Bapak Nengah Sade. Dari kita masih kecil-kecil, yang kendalanya waktu itu cuman di pas ngelilitnya itu memang agak susah, tapi lama-lama jadi terbiasa. Dari resep semua menu yang di sini itu diajarin oleh almarhum Bapak Nengah Sade sampai ke penerus Ibu Wayan Dunia dan saya sendiri. Kita menjaga kualitas rasa dari dulu sampai sekarang, bumbunya itu tetap tidak ada perubahan, tidak ada tambahan, tetap menggunakan bumbu alami. Proses pembuatan sate, dari mengambil ikannya, dibersihin, dipotong-potong, digiling, langsung dibumbuin. Dibumbuin dari bumbu-bumbu rempah alami itu, tidak ada campuran apapun, makanya sate lilit di sini awet.
Mertesari food stall always serves tuna and has the specialities of a processed tuna with Balinese spice menu. This shop always tries to maintain the quality taste of the dish with main spices such as onion, garlic, salt, pepper, sugar, and spices. This tuna meat is seasoned with family recipe and then grilled. The grilling process only takes a few moments. The special recipe also makes the tuna meat tender with a slightly spiced taste combined with herbs and spices. Besides tuna satay, other menus that are also selling well are fish soup, fish satay with soy sauce, fish pepes, and sambal mata, which is different from other stalls. Customers who visit here come and go and will always come back. All of the menus at the Mertasari food stall are family recipes that have been handed down from generations. Even though all the menus are predominantly processed fish, but there is no fishy taste that arises from the taste. This shop growing rapidly so that it has always become a mandatory tourist destination when visiting Bali. The prices of the various menus are affordable with very good quality.
Jumlah karyawan di sini, kami semua 15 orang, itu sudah ada bagian-bagian masing-masing. Ada yang bersihin ikan, ada yang bikin bumbu, ada yang tusuk sate, ada yang lilit, ada yang bungkus pepes, sama yang lain-lainnya itu sudah ada masing-masing ambil sendiri-sendiri. Di sini karyawan juga kita libatkan untuk bikin bumbu, karena kita sudah ngasih tahu racikan-racikannya. Kami tidak takut akan resep diambil, karena kita sudah percaya, karena rezeki itu masing-masing sudah ada yang ngatur. Sejak warung ini buka, kita keluarga tidak menyangka akan jadi sebesar ini. Dulu kita dari jualan kecil-kecilan, dari sore hanya jualan sate-sate aja. Ada banyak pendatang dari luar kota, ada permintaan sedikit-sedikit, terus jadi berkembang seperti ini dari mulut ke mulut. Jadinya kita bersyukur kita dapat rezeki seperti ini. Itu tidak lepas juga dari didikan, bimbingan dari almarhum Bapak Ineng Asadu. Meskipun kita sudah punya karyawan 15, dia sudah mengambil bagiannya masing-masing, tetapi kita, saya dan ibu tetap memonitor supaya kualitas rasa tetap dijaga dan kebersihan tetap dijaga.
Because the tuna used is a fine selection, so it will affect the quality of the satay, because it usually lasts longer and do not break easily when grilled. Visitors can see firsthand the way the satay is grilled by the staff who are skilled at cooking.
Nama saya Nengah Harde. Saya di sini tugasnya ngilit sate. Kerjanya tahun 97. Warung Lesian Mertasarinya buka jam 8, tutupnya jam 5, kadang-kadang bisa jam 6. Saya sangat betah kerja di Lesian Mertasari. Mungkin sama teman-teman baik, sama bosnya juga baik. Apalagi saya kerjanya dekat sama rumah.
Well, sate lilit in Warung Pesinggahan Mertasari Klungkung has uniqueness and also differences with another sate lilit in Bali. Because in this warung, they don't use coconut in the ingredients, but they only use tuna, which is fresh tuna from the fishermen in Pesinggahan Beach. The main course in Warung Pesinggahan Mertasari Klungkung, there are soup ikan tuna, pepes, and also sate lilit. And these are really delicious because they use bumbu basa genep, and without any additional sauce, it is delicious enough. Warung Pesinggahan Mertasari Klungkung has uniqueness because it always serve sate lilit from fresh tuna from the fishermen in Pesinggahan Beach. And it also a pride that Warung Pesinggahan Mertasari Klungkung is one of Ibu Megawati Soekarno Putri's destination in Bali. And I hope that every provinces or another provinces in Indonesia can synergize with culture, preserving culture, because I think that culture is one of our extraordinary legacy for our next generation.
Pada saat ini kita tidak mengirim, ada sih permintaan untuk mengirim karena keterbatasan tenaga dan transportasi. Biasanya diambil langsung ke sini kalau ada permintaan keluar. Semenjak pandemi kemarin, kami berusaha bertahan agar bisa buka seperti biasa. Memang ada penurunan omset, itu banyak, tapi kami berusaha mempertahankan karena kita sudah kerjasama sama karyawan, dia sudah sama-sama mengerti, kita bagi-bagi biar semua bisa masing-masing cari makan agar kedepannya tidak tutup, kita jalan terus. Harapan kami ke depan agar warung lesehan Martasari tetap berkembang seperti ini dan semakin berkembang, semakin ramai dan masih terjaga kualitasnya. Saya sebagai wakil dari keluarga sangat bersyukur, berterima kasih juga sama almarhum Bapak telah merintis warung ini dan mendidik kami agar bertahan supaya bisa mengembangkan Martasari ini bertahan dalam rasa.
The Pasinggahan Village is indeed a tip of an arrow for the seafood satay dish. Although there are many other satay lilit stall here, but they compete in a good way because they uphold goodness and peace of life. Martasari Food Stall is proof that what we strive for will surely get the results tomorrow. That what has been inherited, we must protect for the sake of living together.